Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture on steam nozzle. This is problem part 7. So earlier we solved university question paper up to part 6. Now we solve few more additional university examination questions in the recent Anna University examination. In part 7, and these are all the books I have published earlier. So, design of transmission system, turbo machines, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. And I have a YouTube channel where the video lectures of all the subjects are uploaded. You can visit, you can use the videos for your learning, and also I am uploading the solutions for GATE question paper in various GATE questions. So you can use the videos on GATE solution to make a pass in the GATE examination. And before we take up the problem, we review the properties of the steam, the specific volume of the steam, specific enthalpy of the steam, and specific entropy of the steam. The three different types. For specific volume of wet steam equal to V wet equal to 1 minus x into Vf plus x into Vg, and the specific volume of dry steam equal to V dry equal to Vg, specific volume of superheated steam equal to V super equal to Vg into T by Ts, where Vf, Vg and Ts values are taken from the steam table to the corresponding given pressure, and the specific enthalpy of the steam. Wet steam Hf equal to Hwet equal to Hf plus x into Hfg. For dry steam, H dry equal to Hg, and for superheated steam, H super equal to Hg plus Cp into T minus Ts, where Hf, Hfg, Hg values and Ts value are taken from the steam table. Cp value will be given in the problem. If it is not given, you can assume 2.2. And similarly, for specific entropy of the steam, for wet steam, S wet equal to Sf plus x into Sfg. For dry steam, S dry equal to Sg. And for superheated steam, S super equal to Sg plus Cp into logarithmic of T by Ts. Again, Sf, Sfg, Sg value from the steam table for the given pressure. And this is problem number 9. From Anna University question paper, November 2009, dry saturated steam with an initial pressure of 11 bar is expanded to 1.5 bar through a convergent divergent nozzle. The flow rate of the steam is estimated as 2 kilograms per second. Area of cross section of the nozzle on its throat area is 1 centimeter square. If the efficiency of the nozzle is 88%, find the number of nozzles and exit area. Take the index of expansion equal to 1.2. And this is the convergent divergent nozzle. So the data given, P1, entry pressure 11 bar and it is dry saturated steam. P3, exit pressure equal to 1.5 bar. Mass flow rate equal to 2 kilograms per second. Area at the throat section A2 equal to 1 centimeter square. Nozzle efficiency is 0.88. And index of expansion N equal to 1.2. And from the steam table, for 11 bar and dry saturated steam, we have to take these properties. H1 equal to Hg1, which is 2779.7 kilojoules per kilogram. S1 equal to Sg1, which is 6.55 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And V1 equal to Vg1 equal to 0.17739 metric cube per kilogram. And the extract of the steam table I have shown here for your benefit. And for maximum mass flow rate per unit area at the throat section, m by a equal to square root of 2n by n plus 1 p1 by v1 into 2 by n plus 1 to the power 2 by n minus 1. So substituting all the values, n equal to 1.2, 2 into 1.2 divided by 1.2 plus 1 into p1 equal to 11 bar. So 11 into 10 power 5, we have to substitute in Pascal, divided by v1 equal to 0.17739 into 2 by 1.2 plus 1 to the power 2 by 1.2 minus 1. So calculating the m by a value equal to 1.61 10 power 3, and the m mass flow rate equal to 1.61 10 power 3 into area of the throat section 1 cm² 1 × 10 power minus 4. So the mass flow rate equal to 0.161 kilograms per second. From the steam table, at exit pressure P3 equal to 1.5 bar. So from the steam table, we note down the properties. And 1.5 bar, we take all the properties here. So VF, VG equal to 1.159, HF equal to 467.1, HFG equal to 2226.3, SF equal to 1.433, SFG equal to 5.79. And for isentropic flow, S1 equal to S3. So S1 equal to SF3 plus X3 into SFG3, S1 equal to 6.55, so from the previous page, so we have taken S1 equal to 6.55, so substituting here, S1 equal to 6.55 equal to 1.433 plus X3 into 5.79, so solving this equation, X3 equal to 0.88, so quality of the steam at the exit equal to 0.88. Now the properties at the exit, so H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 HFG3, which is equal to 461.1 plus 0.88 into 226.3 equal to 2426.2 kilojoules per kilogram, and the specific volume V3 equal to X3 into VG3, which is 0.88 into 1.159 equal to 1.02 meter cube per kilogram. Now the velocity at the exit V3 equal to 2 into H1 minus H2 into nozzle efficiency, so which is 2 into square root of 2779.7 minus 2426.2 into 1000 to convert kilojoules into joules into nozzle efficiency 0.88, so calculating V3 equal to 788.77 meters per second, and the area at the exit, so A3 equal to M into V3 small V3 divided by capital V3. Now M we have calculated per nozzle, so mass per nozzle, so 0.161 into 1.02 divided by 788.7 equal to 2.08 into 10 power minus 4 meter square. So the number of nozzles required, total mass flow rate divided by mass flow rate per nozzle, so this equal to 2 by 0.161 equal to 12.4 equal to 13. So we require 13 nozzles for the given mass flow rate of 2 kilograms per second. And example number 10 from November 2012 and November 2014 question paper, steam at a pressure of 10.5 bar and 0.9 dry is expanded through a convergent divergent nozzle. The pressure of the steam leaving the nozzle is 0.85 bar. Find the velocity of the steam at the throat for maximum discharge. Take N equal to 1.135. Also find the area at the exit and the steam discharged if the throat area equal to 1.2 cm². Assume the flow is isentropic and there is no frictional loss. And this is the convergent divergent nozzle. So we are given P1 equal to 10.5 bar and X1 equal to 0.95. So the inlet is wet steam now. P3 exit pressure is 0.85 bar. Index of expansion is 1.135 and area at the throat section A2 equal to 1.2 cm². And the properties of the steam at the P1 equal to 10.5 bar and X1 equal to 0.95, we take the extract of the steam table 10.5 bar, we read all the values, we calculate H1, HF1 plus X1 into HFG1, which is 772, so 772 plus 0.95 into 2006 equal to 2676.7 kilojoules per kilogram, S1 equal to SF1 plus X1 into SFG1, which is 2.159 plus 0.95 into 4.407 equal to 6.34565 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and the specific volume V1 equal to X1 VG1 equal to 0.95 into 0.18548 equal to 0.1762 meter cube per kilogram. All the properties at the inlet of the nozzle. Then to calculate the critical, the throat pressure, so we have to use the critical pressure ratio. So P2 by P1 equal to 2 by n plus 1 to the power n by n minus 1. So P2 equal to 10.5. P1 equal to 10.5 into 2 by 1.135 plus 1 டு தி பவர் 1.135 டிவைட் பை 1.135 மைனஸ் 1 ஈக்குவல் டு 6.1 பார். நவ் அட் தி த்ரோட் ப்ரெஷர் 6.1 பார். So we have to take the properties, but 6.1 bar is not directly available. We have to go for interpolation. We have to take the average of the values. VG2, average of these two values, 0.31546 plus 0.30584 divided by 2. You take the average. This is 0.31065 meter cube per kilogram. HF1, again taking the average, 673.25 kilojoules per kilogram. HFG, so HFG equal to 2082.95 kilojoules per kilogram. SF2 equal to 1.935 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and SFG2 equal to 4.815 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now we have to calculate the dryness fraction at the throat section. So for isentropic flow, S1 equal to S2, so S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So 6.34565 equal to 1.935 plus X2 into 4.815. So solving this equation, X2 equal to 0.92. And the properties of the steam at the throat section, we calculate H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is 673.25 plus 0.92 into 2082.95. equal to 2589.56 kilojoules per kilogram, and the specific volume V2 equal to X2 into VG2, which is 0.92 into 0.31065 equal to 0.2858 meter cube per kilogram. Now the velocity of the steam at the throat section, V2 equal to 2 into square root of 2 into H1 minus H2, so square root of 2 into 2676.7 minus 2589.56 into 1000. So to convert kilojoules into joules, so the answer is 417.5 meters per second. So the throat section, the velocity is 417.5 meters per second. And the mass flow rate of the steam, M equal to A2 V2 by small V2. So area is given as 1.2 centimeter square, 1.2 into 10 power minus 4 into V2 equal to 417.5 divided by specific volume equal to 0.252858. equal to 0.175 kilograms per second. Now we go to the exit section. So from the steam table, at the exit pressure P3 equal to 0.85 bar. Again we take the extract of the steam table. So 0.85 bar is directly available. We note down the properties. VG equal to 1.9721, HF equal to 398.6, HFG equal to 2269.8, SF equal to 1.252, SFG equal to 6.163. And we calculate the dryness fraction for isentropic flow. S1 equal to S3. So S1 equal to SF3 plus X3 into SFG3. So S1 is 6.34565 equal to SF3 equal to 1.252 plus X3 into 6.163. So solving this equation, X3 equal to 0.83. And calculating the properties at the exit, H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 into HFG3 equal to 398.6 plus 0.83 into 2269.8 equal to 2282.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific volume V3 equal to X3 into VG3, which is 0.83 into 1.9721 equal to 1.6368 meter cube per kilogram. Now velocity of the steam at the exit section, V3 equal to 2 into square root of 2 into H1 minus H3 is equal to square root of 2 into 2676.7 minus 2282.5 into 1000 equal to 887.9 meters per second. And we calculate the exit area of the nozzle, A3 equal to M into specific volume divided by velocity at the exit section. So M equal to 0.175 into 1.6368. divided by 887.9 equal to 3.2 to 10 power minus 4 meter square. That is the area. So 3.10 power minus 4 meter square or 3.2 centimeter square. That is the area at the exit of the nozzle. And we take example number 11. So from May 2013 question paper, a convergent divergent nozzle is required to discharge 2 kg of steam per second. The nozzle is supplied with the steam at 7 bar and 180 degree Celsius. And the discharge takes place against a back pressure of 1 bar. The expansion up to the throat is isentropic, and the frictional resistance between the throat and the exit is equal to 63 kJ per k. kilogram of the steam. Taking approach velocity is 75 meters per second. Approach velocity is inlet velocity, 75 meters per second, and the throat pressure is 4 bar. Estimate 1. Suitable area for the throat. Number 2. Overall efficiency of the nozzle based on enthalpy drop between actual inlet pressure and temperature and the exit pressure. So, this is the convergent-divergent nozzle. So, the given data, mass flow rate equal to 2 kilograms per second, pressure P1 equal to 7 bar and temperature T1 equal to 180 degrees Celsius. P3 exit pressure is 1 bar and the QF frictional loss, heat loss due to friction equal to 63 kilojoules per kilogram. V1 equal to 75 meters per second, throat pressure P2 equal to 4 bar. So, from the steam table, so we take the extract of the steam table for 7 bar. The saturation temperature is 165 degrees Celsius, whereas the temperature given equal to 180 degrees Celsius. The steam is superheated steam. Now, we have to calculate the properties of the superheated steam at 180 degrees Celsius at inlet condition. So, the properties of steam at P1 equal to 7 bar and 180 degrees Celsius, H1 equal to HG1 plus Cp into T1 minus TS1, which is 2762 plus 2.2 into 180 minus 165 equal to 2795. Kilojoules per kilogram. S1 equal to SG1 plus Cp into logarithmic of T1 by TS1, which is 6.705 plus 2.2 into logarithmic of 453 divided by 438. Now, here we have to substitute the temperature in Kelvin. This equal to 6.779 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. Now, the properties of the steam at the throat section P2 equal to 4 bar. Again, we take the extract of the steam table and we take the condition S1 equal to S2 for isentropic flow. So, S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So, 6.779 equal to 1.776 plus X2 into 5.118 equal to. So, solving this equation, X2 equal to 0.98. So, the condition of the steam at the throat section, it is wet steam with the drainage fraction 0.98. Now, the calculate the properties, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2. Which is 604.7 plus 0.98 into 2132.9 equal to 2694.94 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific volume V2 equal to X2 into VG2, which is 0.98 into 0.4622 equal to 0.4529 meter cube per kilogram. And the velocity at the throat section V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2, which is square root of 2 into 2795. Minus 2694.94 into 1000 equal to 447.3 meters per second. Now, area at the throat section A2 equal to MV2, M into specific volume divided by the velocity. So, 2 into 0.4529 divided by 447.3 equal to 2.02 in 10 power minus 3 meters per. That is the throat area. That is one question. So, from the steam table, at exit pressure P3 equal to 1 bar, we take the properties extract of the table. We read the value 1 bar, VG equal to 1.6938, HF equal to 417.5, HFG equal to 2257.9, SF equal to 1.303 and SFG equal to 6.057. So, for isentropic flow in the nozzle, S1 equal to S3, so S1 equal to SF plus X3 into SFG3. So, 6.779 equal to 1.307 plus X3 into 6.048. So, solving this equation, X3, drainage fraction at the exit, X3 equal to 0.9. And we calculate the properties of the steam at the exit, H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 into HFG3 equal to 417.5 plus 0.9 into 2257.9 equal to 2449.6 kilojoules per kilogram. And the specific volume V3 equal to X3 into VG3, which is 0.9 into 1.6938 equal to 1.5244 meter cube per kilogram. That is the property at the exit. Now, we calculate the actual enthalpy at the exit considering the heat loss H3 dash equal to H3 plus QF, which is 2449.6 plus 63 equal to 2512.6 kilojoules per kilogram. And we have to calculate the nozzle efficiency here. So, nozzle efficiency equal to actual enthalpy drop divided by the isentropic enthalpy drop. Actual enthalpy drop is H1 minus H3 dash divided by H1 minus H3, which is 2795 minus 2512.6 divided by 2749 minus 2449.6 equal to 0.8176 equal to 81.76%. Then example number 12 from November 2018 question paper. Dry saturated steam at 2.8 bar is expanded through a convergent nozzle to 1.7 bar. The exit area is 3 cm square. Calculate the exit velocity and the mass flow rate for 1 isentropic flow, 2 supersaturated flow. So this is the convergent nozzle. So the given data, so P1 equal to 2.8 bar and it is dry saturated steam. P2 equal to 1.7 bar. So, A2 area at the exit equal to 3 cm square. So, the properties of the steam at 2.8 bar and the dry saturated steam. So, I have taken the extract of the steam table. So, I read the value H1 equal to HG1 equal to 2721.5 kilojoules per kilogram. S1 equal to SG1 equal to 7.014 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And V1 equal to VG1 equal to 0.646 meter cube per kilogram. Now, for 1.7 bar at the exit, again we take the properties and we assume that it is wet steam at the exit. Because it is dry steam at the inlet, necessarily the steam will be wet at the exit condition. So, S1 equal to S2. So, S1 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SFG2. So, 7.014 equal to 1.475 plus X2 into 5.706. Equal to solving this equation, X2, the dryness fraction of the exit, X2 equal to 0.97, and the enthalpy and the velocity, enthalpy and the specific volume, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, so which is 483.2 plus 0.97 into 2215.8 equal to 2612.5 kilojoules per kilogram, and specific volume V2 equal to X2 into VG2, which is 0.97 into 1.0309. Which is 1 meter cube. For isentropic flow, the exit velocity and the mass flow rate, V2 equal to square root of 2 into H1 minus H2, which is square root of 2 into 2721.1 minus 2612.5 into 1000 equal to 466.9 meters per second, and the mass flow rate equal to A2 V2 by small V2, so 3 into 10 power minus 4. So the area, exit area is given as 3 centimeter square. So 3 into 10 power minus 4 into velocity 466.9 divided by specific volume 1. So it equal to 0.14 kilograms per second. Now for the supersaturated flow, we calculate the velocity using this equation. V2 equal to square root of 2 into n by n minus 1 P1 V1 into 1 minus P2 by P1 to the power n minus 1 by n. So, substituting all the values, so n equal to 1.135 for the entry condition, dry saturated steam. So, 2 into 1.135 divided by 1.135 minus 1 into 2.8 into 10 power 5. So, entry pressure is 2.8 bar. So, 2.8 into 10 power 5 and the specific volume at the entry is 0.646 multiplied by 1 minus pressure, exit pressure 1.7 divided by 2.8 to the power 1.135 minus 1 divided by 1.135. Calculating the velocity equal to 418.8 meters per second. And the mass flow rate, M equal to A2 V2 by small V2 equal to 3 into 10 power minus 4 into 418.8 equal to 0.1256 kilogram per second. So, what we observe, so for the supersaturated flow, velocity is 418.8 and the area equal to 0.1256 kilograms per second. And for the isentropic flow, the velocity is 466.9 meters per second. And the mass flow rate is 0.14 kilograms per second. So, when there is supersaturated flow, the velocity and the mass flow rate, they are decreasing. So, there is decrease in velocity and decrease in mass flow rate of the steam in the steam nozzle when there is supersaturated flow. That is what our observation. So, we stop here. So, thank you for watching. And please comment, post your comments on the YouTube comments box so that it will be useful. And if you have any queries, you can write to my mail ID or WhatsApp for any clarification. So, I will sincerely answer. So, thank you for watching. We will meet again in the next video with additional problems on the steam nozzle.